Each year, workers rest for a day as they celebrate their contribution to the country through the different sectors they serve in. In Uganda, national celebrations are held in different districts depending where government finds it appropriate. The day is celebrated in over 100 countries worldwide with an aim of celebrating the contribution of workers in the world of business with advocacy in fighting for their rights. The history dictates that this day was fixed to mark the success of the workers' movement and trade unionists that exonerated workers from being harassed by employers in the United States. Asha Wilson Owere is the chairman National Organization of Trade Unions.
Most importantly for Uganda, I would say the man who was very entrenched in liberating Ugandans, both political and even the workers, was Agnesius Musazi. That was in 1939-37 when he started the struggle. When there was a problem here, I think it started as a drivers association, because people by then, the Indians were the one even controlling, doing business, even driving taxis. So they said no. Why are these people undermining us? So they took up that struggle.
Owere says the essence of marking this day is to emphasize the need to protect workers from unfair treatment by the employers and recognizing their contribution towards the development of any business. His sentiments are shared by Sam Ryomoki, the workers' member of parliament. He adds that despite setting laws to protect workers, there is no political will to implement them.
But the challenge is that these labor laws have not been implemented. They have not been enforced, and this is because of the fact that our Ministry of Labor has not been functional. It has not performed the way it is supposed to perform because of low funding, but also because of the fact that the Ministry of Labor has been degraded to a department. So we have a department within a ministry which has a lot of issues. So why you see workers saying we have bad labor laws and the challenges in this, and the point is because of non-enforcement of these labor laws.
These trade union leaders are well aware that the employees are not entirely happy as they execute their duties. The major challenge is lack of a minimum wage to match their output and experience.
We also want to see the bill which is before Parliament, which is before the Committee of Gender, Labour and Social Development, to go to the floor of the House, because that law will help in a way that it is going to streamline, because the minimum wage law which is there has been overtaken by events. And no, it was made in 1950s. Now we are in the 20th century. So you cannot compare what was there to now.
Most of the countries in the US and others are now following the new thinking that you pay workers adequately, optimally, then you have high competitiveness. But our Ministry of Finance have always insisted that we should not have a minimum wage, claiming that minimum wage will lead to high costs of labor and high costs of investments, and therefore using the old thinking. So this has been the challenge. So even as we have been battling for minimum wage, every time our recommendations go to the president, his excellency the president, the Minister of Labor, Minister of Finance, discourages the president.
But Uganda Manufacturers Association Executive Director Mubarak Chirunda thinks otherwise about the minimum wage. He says, given the current economic situation, this is not applicable.
When you look at our situation as of now, I think it should still be willing worker, willing employer, as of now, after that negotiation. Because if we start fixing the minimum wage as of now, you may find that it will be overstraining to some of the employers, maybe. Some of these industries are still in their infancy, and they need to work out a system where they can break even.
It can be done sector by sector. Not saying, okay, we bring a minimum wage and this should be one like this. No. No, we are saying, let agriculture department sector, let media and other sectors have minimum wage.
Umabo says the quality of some employees in Uganda do not require a minimum wage.
At times you find that some workers may not measure to the desired goals for the employers. And that's where at times our employers have gone ahead to complain about the quality of skills that the employers they take on do have.
We must be able to challenge government, and government must be able to change its viewpoint about workers and to understand that labor is the motive force to development.
Unusually, this year's Labor Day celebrations are marked when the Labor Ministry is vacant after the suspension of Herbert Kabafunzachi for allegedly taking a bribe from an employer, also an investor, to frustrate investigations into alleged sexual harassment of a worker. Workers' leaders are bitter about this.
The labor officer, who is very central in the law, being transported, for instance, by an employer. If I'm going to investigate a situation in a workplace, and the employer is the one giving me money, the employer is, of course, I'm compromised.
We are very clear to the appointing authority that for us, as far as the minister is concerned, his integrity is now questionable. He cannot be our minister.
So, given all the challenges faced by employees across the country, is there still a need to celebrate this day?
I don't think we need to celebrate because why we don't need to celebrate is because we talked about the issue of the minimum wage. The issue of the minimum wage is an issue to be discussed. Where is the minimum wage?
There's a need to celebrate. One, that we thank God that at least jobs are there. But of course, there's a lot more that probably needs to be done to protect workers.
Those who can celebrate are those who are earning very well, but those who are not earning very well, then there is no need of celebrating.
How should I celebrate a Labor Day yet I don't have a job?
When you talk to many Ugandans, especially those working in big companies headed by investors, they are all crying for a minimum wage. It is now evident that government has taken long to pass this bill that is before Parliament. When you talk to legislators, they are saying that the law is still before the Committee on Gender, Labour and Social Development. While others believe in this Labour Day, some are saying that it is not even necessary for Ugandan workers to celebrate this. The question is, how soon can government table and pass this bill into law for Ugandans to enjoy? Mubarak Mugabo, Urban Television.